about power and oppression. And for me, it looks at a very central question of the clash between the liberal democracies of the Islamic civilizations. And it is that question, what is this clash, that I think it plays about.
Well, Djinns deals with the situation in Kashmir today, and it looks at the life of ordinary Kashmiris and tells the story through their eyes of what it's like to live in the most militarized place in the planet, and the stories of young children in that world and how they can hope and dream and move forward with their lives. So it sort of looks at this incredibly complex problem of Kashmir.
I think one of the most interesting responses I've heard were from some children who are 14, 13, who told me that how come they are not taught about Kashmir in their history textbooks. And we did a class on Kashmir, which was very interesting.
I think this is a play which is really necessary. In many ways, the situation in Kashmir has fallen off the map in Western politics. It's a situation that actually, if you look into the news, there is developments, there are killings, there are murderings, there are torturings, there are incarcerations every single day pretty much in Kashmir. The other half of this play is that it also looks at an Islamic form of storytelling called the dastan, and it takes that form, which is an incredibly theatrical, playful form, and merges it together with these real human stories to create a kind of theatrical piece which is at once both real and completely unreal.
A lot of it is based on real stories, and this is something I often say about Djinns in all interviews, that the thing with Kashmir or Iraq or Afghanistan or any of these places is that a writer possibly cannot make up anything which is more absurd than what the reality is.
It's a sort of story of sort of, I guess, human resilience and hope in an incredibly traumatic and difficult environment.